Hi, I'm Chad with Mastercam, and in this video, I want to show you some tips for analyzing entity association. A Mastercam entity becomes associative the moment another entity, plane, or toolpath references it. The simplest example of associativity would be to draw a circle and then extrude that circle into a cylinder. If you attempt to then delete the wireframe circle, Mastercam will warn you that you are attempting to delete a referenced entity. If you were to delete that referenced entity, the solid cylinder would no longer be a valid solid since you have deleted the geometry that it is based on. When dealing with very large part files with lots of geometry, planes, and toolpaths, associativity can be very complex to manage. Luckily, there is new functionality inside of Mastercam 2020 that makes this much easier and more transparent. If I draw a circle and extrude it into a cylinder in Mastercam 2020, when I go to delete the circle, I'm still presented with the same referenced entity dialog, but there is a new control in the dialog that will allow me to see the associations. If I cancel out of the dialog, select both the wireframe circle and the solid cylinder, and press delete, I'm not prompted with a dialog because the delete operation will not leave an entity that was associated behind. This new functionality can be extremely helpful when organizing large or complex files. Let's look at another example. In this file, I have a series of dynamic OptiRough operations. Generally, each of these operations will have its own containment boundary to help control the tool motion, and just like any other geometry I select for use with my toolpaths, that means the containment geometry is now associative to the toolpath. My normal workflow is to place all my containment geometry onto one level, so it's easy to turn it on and off as needed. However, the amount of geometry can begin to become unmanageable in large files, and it's helpful to be able to quickly remove the geometry I'm not using to clean up the file structure. On this level, there are 91 entities. If I right-click on the level and select Delete Entities, I'm prompted that there are referenced entities. By clicking the dropdown, I can see all the operations that are using the various entities, and I can right-click on any of the entities to isolate, analyze, or remove them from the delete operation at this point. I'll delete only the non-associative entities, and now the count on that level has gone from 91 to 13. This associativity information is incredibly helpful, but we don't need to be deleting an entity to see its information. We can also access it with the Analyze Entity command. I can launch Analyze Entity from the Home tab, or I can simply click on an entity and press F4. If the entity is associative to anything in the part file, the associativity button will be available in the dialog. By clicking it, I can quickly see what geometry, planes, or toolpaths are associated with it. In this example, I can see that this piece of geometry is being used by operations 12 and 13. In previous versions of Mastercam, I would have to enable the Only Display Associated Geometry options and toggle through the toolpaths until I found the correct one. Using associativity is a great way to keep your part files organized and free of clutter, or just to quickly locate toolpaths, planes, or geometry based on their association to something else in the file.